first female African-American engineer in America was? Most people could not name me. I am Mary Jackson. In 1951, I went to work as a human computer at the Langley Memorial Aeronautical Laboratory Segregated West Computing Area, or NASA. I, Mary Winston Jackson, followed in my parents' footsteps by always helping others be successful. However, I also worked to become America's first African-American female engineer, proving that race and gender don't define a person. I was born April 9, 1921. As I was growing up, my family and I did a lot of service. Our motto was sharing and caring. Like my 10 older siblings and my parents, I went to the Hampton Institute. When I graduated college, I received my Bachelor of Science degree in Mathematics and Physical Science. After several different careers, I went to work at NASA as a human computer. I was in the computing pool for around 5 years when my supervisor began encouraging me to aim higher. I soon became determined to become an engineer and nothing could stand in my way. I started taking extra classes at the Hamilton Center of the University of Virginia. In order to take these classes, I had to get special permission from the city because they were hosted at an all-white school. Soon after taking these classes, I became an engineer in training. One day at work, I was sent to the east side. I was surrounded by white women. Everything was going just as normal. That is, until I needed to use the restroom. It doesn't sound like something that should be a big deal, but when I asked where the bathrooms were, I was laughed at, and the white women responded, "How should we know where your bathroom is?" I was forced to run back to my building on the west side, completely humiliated. In that moment, I had been a mathematician demoted to a second-class human being, reminded that I was just a black girl whose piss wasn't good enough for the white pot. On my way back to the east side from the restroom, I ran into the assistant section head in the 4x4-foot supersonic pressure tunnel. His name was Kaz. When Kaz greeted me, I poured out all my anger and frustration about what had happened with the women to him. Since I didn't know him, I'm not sure what I was expecting his response to be, but it was absolutely shocking. "Why don't you come work with me?" he offered, and of course I agreed without hesitation. This was a turning point in my career. As an engineer, I worked with Kaz in the 4x4-foot supersonic pressure tunnel, helping to make sure the spaceships we sent out were as efficient as possible. Sadly, after just over 3 decades as an engineer, I realized I would never become supervisor, no matter my qualifications. I decided to leave NASA and work as an equal rights opportunity specialist. I was able to assist many people into getting the jobs and recognition they deserve. I'm considered notable for many reasons. Not only was I one of the first female engineers in the U.S., I was the first African-American female engineer. I have inspired many to follow their dreams and to never put restrictions on themselves. I've gotten kids interested in STEM subjects outside of school with a science club, and I was a Girl Scout troop leader. My work at NASA has changed lives. My work in the science club and my work in the Girl Scouts have broken many stereotypes. I once said, their dark skins, their gender, their economic status, none of those are acceptable excuses for not giving their full range to their imaginations and ambitions. You can do better, we can do better. I am an important part of American history, yet very few people have heard of me. Why is that? My story has been kept secret for quite some time, but has recently been released for the world to see in the form of a movie and a book, both called Hidden Figures. My most famous and possibly most impactful quote was said when my supervisor asked, "If you were a white male, would you wish to be an engineer?" And I responded, "I wouldn't have to, sir. I'd already be one." I, Mary Winston Jackson, followed in my parents' footsteps by always helping others be successful. However, I also worked to become America's first African-American female engineer, proving that race and gender don't define a person. Throughout my life, I did a great deal of service, defied stereotypes, and inspired many. Whether I was unheard of or not, I am an important part of American history. I've helped many to see that they are more important than what society tells them.